Antony, yet another new experience. What do you make of it so far?
I'm not too sure. I haven't competed here yet. Last time we were just down the road, last time I come to Wales. I've definitely kept up with social media, and I've seen some of the videos. It's looking lively from the videos. It's definitely looking lively.
Carlos Takam, the opponent this time around, you've been saying all week you cannot afford to take him lightly.
Yeah, I've been thinking that. And before I left, I said a little prayer. Carlos, and I just like, no matter if the guy is an ant or he's King Kong, you have to take him seriously, because sometimes they're smarter, sometimes they're stronger, some of them are quicker. So I don't know what Carlos Takam has, but he has something that's got him to this level. So I can't underestimate him. I've got to take him serious and find a way to beat him.
But at the same time, you've got to deliver.
Yeah, that's what it's about. And as we always remember, there's a lot of people that come out to see a good show. So we have to deliver in good fashion.
Good luck, AJ. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Relaxed, calm. And he's been wonderful in Cardiff all week. He's got up close with the fans. And he's a credit to the sport, just like Katie Taylor is. Anna E. Sanchez sticking with Taylor, sticking to the task, trying to survive what's been a bit of a boxing lesson at times. Knocked down in the second round, and Taylor beginning to really deliver now. Late on, can she get the stoppage, Carl?
I'm not sure she'll get the stoppage, because Sanchez seems to be very tough. She's been down to the body. She's taken a fair share of headshots. So I can see her toughing this one out till the end. I mean, she's seasoned. She's a world champion. I don't think she's going to go away. But Katie Taylor doing everything, in my opinion, that she needs to do to win this title.
Yet the danger's now complacent.
She does. She goes for the grandstand finish even when she doesn't have to. She can sit behind that sharp, effective jab that she's got. She uses so well in the amateurs. But she opts to stay in range and throw her hooks and, you know, try and work the body. When she could actually sit back now behind her jab, put on a boxing masterclass.
Just grimacing. Sanchez. Looking at a corner. Trying to get a right hand home. And you're right, toughing this one out. Trying to find a gap away. She's got 9 stoppages on the slate. She needs one now, Sanchez.
Nice work there. We're seeing in the replay from that last round. Sanchez not happy looking at the referee, but there's nothing wrong with the work there. Maybe a little bit of frustration from Sanchez. Another relentless round from Katie Taylor. Another round to her on my card. Heads coming together there, a little bit dangerous. That's the danger when you stay in range and exchange blows and opt to stand and have a fight when you don't need to. You can catch an elbow or catch a head and end up with a cut that you don't need. But that's how Katie Taylor goes about business, and it works very well for her.
Taylor has done 8 rounds with Milena Kuleva earlier in the year, but this is the first time she's heard the bell for the 9th round. Sanchez has been 10 on 3 occasions, so she's used to this. Right, Taylor wants to finish it.
Right hand there from Taylor looked like it hurt Sanchez as she stumbled forward, maybe just caught cold at the start of that round, but these right hands at some point have got to start having an effect.
And another one.
She just times it so well as Sanchez comes forward. Taylor just waiting with that right hand. It's almost a hook, straight right hand. She loops it round, and when it lands with full force. Sanchez, very, very tough.
Plows forward, Sanchez. But straight into the sweet fists of Katie Taylor. Who's won inspirational awards this year. She's a fantastic ambassador. The kids look up to her. The girls are getting in the gyms. It's terrific to see, isn't it?
It really is fantastic. You know, she inspires a lot of young girls and women who, you know, just going down the gym to keep fit, and it just shows that there's no limits really for what these girls can do. I mean, Katie Taylor coming in the ring tonight in this crowd, to, you know, looks like she's going to take this world title. I don't want to speak too soon because we're only in round 9. There's still another round after this, but she's in control and looking really good.
And for someone as ruthless and relentless in the ring, she's such a humble, almost like a choir girl, isn't she, out of it?
She is, yeah, so softly spoken. You wouldn't think that she could get in there and fight like this when you hear her talk.
Still, she probably wants the knockout. Arms down of Sanchez, as if to say, what do I have to do? Heads cracking together again. It's been rough at times. It's been a good learning fight, this, for Katie Taylor, too.
Well, this is all padding out the experience, and, you know, it's new territory here in round 9. She's never been here. Looks like she'll be going into round 10 also. She'll just be gaining so much knowledge, boxing knowledge, ring craft and experience with this fight. This will just take her on to that next level.
Katie Taylor, surely just 2 minutes away from being crowned world champion. Here's a world champion. And the noise inside as Antony Joshua is put on the big screens here. It's quite something. It's going to be deafening, isn't it, when he walks out in a little while.
It really will be deafening. The noise.
To take care of, Katie Taylor looks like she's done her part. 2 minutes away from becoming a world professional champion within a year of turning pro. Have you given Ana E. Sanchez anything, despite her efforts, her tenacity, her bravery, for getting up off the floor off that body shot? Can you give her a round at all?
I nearly gave her a share of the round, but Katie Taylor's work rate was too much. And, you know, you can't go against work rate. If the work rate and the punches are being thrown and landed, you have to score to the fighter that does that. And Katie Taylor has done that from round 1 right through to this final round in round 10. She just...